Hello viewers, you are welcome to this video. Today I want to share with you the things you have to know before you pursue your PhD program. Yes, some of you are thinking of pursuing a PhD program. What are the things you have to know before you get into the program? Yes, you can't just say that I want to do a PhD without knowing what I'm going to share with you. Now, first of all, PhD simply means Doctor of Philosophy. Doctor of Philosophy. Now, Doctor of Philosophy is the highest university degree that is conferred on an individual after a course of study. Yes. And this is done by most universities in the world. How is one awarded a PhD? Yes. How is one awarded a PhD degree? Before one is awarded a PhD degree, one is expected to produce original research that expands the frontiers or boundaries of knowledge. In other words, one is expected to contribute significantly to knowledge. Normally, one is expected to produce theses. Yes, theses or dissertation. And this thesis is normally defended before experts in that field. And these experts are normally appointed by the universities. Yes, so if you want to get a PhD, these are the things. Yes, you should be willing or should be ready to contribute significantly to knowledge, no matter how small the contribution is. Now, PhD is a long road, and whoever pursues PhD program should be willing to learn along the road. PhD is a journey, and if you embark on that journey, you should be willing to learn along the journey. Viewers, I want to share with you these things. If you want to pursue your PhD, first of all, you should be financially sound. Yes. Why am I saying this? A lot of money goes into PhD. If you are not lucky to get a scholarship, you have to pay fees. And it is not a joke. You have to pay a huge amount of money. And you need money to do so many other things. We need money to get books. We need money to publish some of your results. We need money to get data for research. Yes, so before you even think of a PhD, you should be financially sound. Because if you're not financially sound, you don't even have a peace of mind to do the PhD. Yes. Now, viewers, you should also have a peaceful learning environment. Peaceful learning environment. Yes, you can't be doing PhD in an environment which is not conducive for learning. Yes, because you need to have a peace of mind. You need to concentrate. So, you should have a peaceful learning environment. Three, you should be prepared to stay healthy. Yes, you should be prepared to stay healthy. Maybe you are the type who doesn't care about what you eat. When you study, if you want to start a PhD, then you should be prepared to eat well. You should be prepared to exercise regularly, because a healthy mind lives in a healthy body. You should be prepared to pursue non-academic activities. For example, you can decide to have a hobby. The fact that you are doing PhD doesn't mean that you should be learning all the time. No. You shouldn't learn intensively and burn out. Some people, they will learn continuously and then they will have a mental problem. No. So you should have a hobby. so that from time to time you can go and then get yourself involved in that hobby. You should also get a good foundation for the program. You can't start a PhD without having a good master's degree. Yes. And if you have a good master's degree, it doesn't mean that you can straight away get into your PhD program. You should get a very good foundation in the field. Yes, for example, if you want to get into mathematical optimization, you need to know what pertains in the area. Yes, what are the major concepts there? You should know before you get into it. Now, you should also be ready to think critically and analytically. You can't be doing PhD and then you take things the way they are. No. When you read something, you just take it just like that. You should be able to analyze issues. You should be able to analyze concepts. You should be able to analyze methods. And you should be able to criticize the papers you read, the articles you read. Why are they using this method? Yes, why are they using this approach? You should be able to think critically and analytically. Now, you should also be ready to do wide by focused learning. Yes, when you are doing PhD, you have to read widely. But that doesn't mean that you should lose focus. Maybe you are researching on something. Yes, doesn't mean that you should read everything in the world. Some people, when they are doing their PhD, they want to know everything in the world. No, if you do that, you can't complete your PhD. No. So your reading should be wide but focused. Yes, because when you are going, you have to narrow to a point. So PhD to narrow to a point. You want to become an expert in a particular field. You can't be an expert in all the fields. No. So you should do what you call wide but focused learning. Now, viewers, you should also be emotionally and psychologically matured. Yes, you can't do a PhD if you are not tough. So psychologically, you should be matured. If you are not matured, when you get into the program and then you encounter one or two problems, you'll be tempted to stop. You'll be tempted to abandon the program. Somebody can even make a statement and that can just change your mind. That can just end your goal. Yes. And then emotionally, if you are not mature, somebody can make a statement and you'll be angry. You can be angry and for that matter, disrespect your supervisors, your examiners, and so on and so forth. So, if you want to pursue a PhD, you should be emotionally and psychologically mature. Yes, you should also find top journals in your field of study, in your area of study. Why am I saying this? Let's assume that I want to get into mathematical modeling. You should be able to identify the top journals in the field. Now, when you identify the top journals in the field, you go there, read articles. When you read the articles, in the course of reading the articles, you know the gaps that are existing in that field. And that will help you to get your topic. That will help you to know that, oh, this is how things are done here. I've read this article and I've seen that this is a method they used. I've seen that this is the approach they used. I've seen that there's an algorithm. Can I alter the algorithm to get my own algorithm? Will my algorithm be better than theirs? Yes. But if you don't find top journals in your field, getting a topic will be very, very difficult. Because you want to contribute to knowledge. So you need to get the existing gaps in your field of study. Yes. And viewers, When you're able to do that, then you try to get a smart topic. You can't pick a topic which is too broad. You have to choose what I term as a smart topic. Smart topic. Now, your topic should be specific. That is the S. Should be specific. Your topic should be measurable. Your topic should be achievable or attainable. Your topic should be relevant. And finally, your topic should be timely. Yes. And then, viewers, the final point is that to be successful in your PhD program, you need to get good supervisors. Don't just say that I've heard of a professor who is very good in a particular field, and because of that, you want to work with that professor. Will the professor get time for you? Is he or she accessible? Will the professor also think about your work? Will the professor be concerned about the number of years you use to complete your PhD? These are the questions you have to ask yourself. Yes, because there are some professors, they can frustrate you. They can abandon you. They will not be bothered about the number of years you use to complete the program. So, viewers, these are the 10 things I want to share with you if you are thinking of pursuing a PhD program. Thank you very much for your attention. For more of this video, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Shamala Junior. Thank you very much.